St Kilda coach Scott Watters expects Stephen Milne to be on the playing field again within a month, despite facing four charges of rape relating to an alleged incident 9 years ago. His teammates say they are comfortable with Milne's indefinite leave of absence imposed by the Saints, the club hosing down reports of a player revolt. Rob Watters with more.
Stephen Milne is pressing on, the training track a familiar sanctuary. He is said to have come to the view a spell on the sidelines is wise. The AFL has no doubts.
I think out of respect for the woman involved, and I think out of respect for Stephen Milne's welfare, particularly after, you know, a 9-year lapse since this incident occurred, that it's proper that he not play this week.
While the players were initially angry he was stood down, the club denies they were close to a revolt. Publicly, they are on the same page.
I think the playing group's all really comfortable with where it sits, and Stephen's comfortable, so that's the main concern for the players. And from now, we've got a job to do and trying to win a game of football tomorrow.
I actually think the player rebellion term's almost laughable.
But both the AFL and St Kilda say Milne is entitled to play again this year and will.
By denying him the opportunity to participate in his profession, he might not ever play football again, and that would seem to be unjust given what we all understand and appreciate about the presumption of innocence.
Stephen will return to play. We'd be very hopeful that, you know, within 3 to 4 weeks he's available to come back out and do what he loves doing.
The Saints had planned to celebrate the two Knicks, Del Santo and Revolt, playing game number 250 tomorrow, but there has been no joy this week.
And our supporters will certainly look forward to coming to the game to watch them play. Oh, I think they're superstars of the game.
Their milestones have been lost in the Milne controversy. Rob Waters, 10 News.